Good morning, this is Axel from the Metamorphic Weight. Sunday is going to be 23 degrees in London. Bikini, bikini. No. Okay, guys. Oops. Here we go. Oh, boy, here we go. Oh, good. Good, 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 good. I think we have almost all the... Do we have already the card? Yes, we have all the cards already. Man. And we have an extra card. Boom. Right. Confinement. It's going well, as you can see. So, first card, first. That is very close, isn't it? Yeah, Excel, I feel so sick. Okay. Guys, first of all, are you carry on doing the challenge with Chloe Ting? She is amazing. I mean, she's killing me. It's getting better every day, though, I have to say. And I can feel my waist going a little bit like, yes, come on, let's do this. Okay, first thing first, Two of Pentacles. So you're either juggling a little bit too much at the moment, probably work from home, kids from home. It's a lot from home, isn't it? Breathe, just. Chill. So yeah, maybe you have also a decision to make. Again, this kind of it's a kind of a pattern repeating itself as a pattern. Woodoo Excel, hello. Yes, this may be a choice to make. We're gonna cover all of this, but anyways, it's two directions you can go to, two offers, two persons. You busy little bunny, aren't you? Anyway, so yes, and then we have, well, 11-11, Four of Wands, which is celebration, completion, awards. I mean, let's do this, okay? This is wonderful. And then we have the High Priestess. High Priestess is very intuitive, very magnetic, very spiritual, very mysterious, sensual. You name it. She's very, really intriguing, definitely. You don't really know where to go with this lady or this person. Doesn't have to be a lady, but the situation is really kind of pushing your buttons. Something like bringing maybe a little bit of a devil energy, which is a bit of obsession toward that person. So that's cool. And then, and that's just under the Two of Pentacles, we have the Five of Pentacles. So yes, that could go together actually, because you are feeling sorry for yourself. You are kind of in between two kind of situation, a bit of foot in the past, another, you know, in the future, even though you don't really see what's presenting to you, what is presented to you at the moment. You kind of dwelling on the past and how life used to be and blah blah blah. Boring, but you don't see what's actually presenting right now and potential of massive success right there, either financially or other. But no, I feel sorry for myself. Look, terrifying. Anyway, you're not gonna stay like that for very long because we have this one. So, Judgment is, as you can see, they're kind of naked. I'm not saying you have to be naked, but you're going to be brought to the core of your being. You're going to be brought to what is important to you, and the confinement period is doing just that. If you find yourself having nothing in common with the person you're living with, suddenly it's going to blow in your face. Maybe you're going to realize the job you've been doing for the last 20 years is seriously not what you want to do for the next 20 years. You're going to bring back to the core. So yes, at the same time, this card, Judgment, is, yeah, you're gonna get what you deserved. Not only, by the way, because at the end of the day, I like to believe most people are good people. They're trying their best in sometimes very difficult situations, so there's no judgment in that way. However, it's very often a situation where you may have put a lot of effort for many, many, many years, either in a job or in a relationship, and you feel almost invisible. You feel like doesn't really matter, it will never be good enough, it will never be perfect, you barely have you know, something positive said to you. You generally are being picked on for the tiny little thing, little details that are seriously not important. And in that period of pandemic, you just think, really, you will think what is important in life and what is not. So yeah, you're going to actually put a judgment on your life at the moment, the people who are around you, do they deserve to be around you? That's more like it. You know, you're not going to be judged, you're going to be the one who judge. And again, I mean, this one is living in this card, isn't it? The Emperor, again. I don't know, I mean, it's once a day we have this boy, okay? Bad boy, bad boy. This bad boy, is he knows what he wants. So maybe you're going to regain, you know, confidence. You're going to trust yourself more, you're going to appreciate them. Yes, you can make things happen. You prove it to yourself many times. You're very resilient. You do what needs to be done and you make things happen. So even though you're juggling, you're capable of success, but you're a little bit intrigued by, you know, who someone is intriguing you, you're dwelling a little bit, maybe you'd be scared of taking that, doing that judgment and realizing, okay, this is working, this is not working, period. And put your foot down, more or less, you know, regain your authority. That's the way I see it. And then, well, the result is that, do we need to cover those cards? Not quite sure, actually, but we will do anyway because we are naughty like this. And then we have this one, Eight of Cups. What do you want me to say? You moving on. You don't look back because you have a place to go on top of the world. Why would you like to stay in your middle ground when you can go on top of the world? I don't get it. Personally, I'm going for the top of the world. Oh yeah, oh yeah. Too much dancing on Sunday. Anyway, and then what we have? The Magician. Magician is going to bring the movement, but first, before you move, you have to go in a certain direction. And the Magician is going to show you that direction. So maybe at the moment, you are in a position where you, at that stage, I should say, where you actually see the direction you have to take. You might not be ready to actually go there, but you, and you might not even be sure on the how you're going to make it there, but you are aware this is where you're going to go. That's sometimes that's all you need, you know. Rest will be you know, discover later on down the road, but for now all you need to know is, like, you need to move. That's enough, that's good enough. Let's cover though. Okay, so the two of pentacles is covered by the Four of Swords, which is about period of healing, period of resting. Maybe if you have too much to juggle, that makes sense to actually take a time out if you can, and just breathe a little bit. Let's take a breather, really. That's what it is more about. And then that will bring you balance. Six of Pentacles, so yes, more equal give and take. So yeah, at the moment you're juggling too much. Maybe it's not a question of choice, it's more a question of, this is what's happening and it's a bit too much. So you need to, it's Sunday today, take a time off. My hair is insane and nothing new there. Okay, and when it comes to for the one, I don't need to cover. Okay, I think it's just brilliant, and that's all we need to know. And the High Priestess are covered by the Hangman, so maybe a change of perspective, maybe a statu quo, maybe, you know, yeah, appreciating what you've done already so far, realizing your value, because sometimes when you look back and reflect on what you already achieved, that gives you more self-belief, because you realize, I've done all of that, remember, I did this. And sometimes we don't remember because you just carry on with life, you move on, you carry on moving, but it is true, you've done all of those things, you survived them all, and you're gonna, you know, just do even better things. So yeah, just appreciate your success. There's still though the Two of Swords, so maybe yes, it's still a bit of that idea of choice, decision to make. Maybe at the moment, you know, as you can see, you can't really see much and you can't maybe make that decision just yet, but that's okay. Whatever the moon, whatever needs to be uncovered will be uncovered, and you will see the reality. And yes, you have the King of Swords. King of Swords is Libra, and it's really powerful because the Libra like justice, like balance, like harmony, doesn't like conflict. So he will do everything he can or she can to remove any cause of conflict. However, life is not just like that, you know. However, he's going to keep and make sure he keeps the appearance of calm and dignity from the outside. However, inside you have a little butterfly. So maybe he has butterflies for somebody at the moment. And that's okay. You are alive. You don't have dead. Enjoy, okay? Butterflies are so good. And then we have the Queen of Swords. This one, she's going to make whatever, you know, necessity, whatever is necessary, that will be made. If there's a decision, if there's a choice, that will just happen, definitely. And yes, definitely Ace of Cups. You know, when you see that you have the Eight of Cups and the Ace of Cups as well, then you appreciate that. It's definitely you leaving behind what doesn't work anymore. You really, you can't even, that decision is almost made for you. There's nothing to dwell on. That's it. I mean, this chapter is over, and you know for a while you maybe have been battling because you want to maintain a certain appearance. You don't want people to talk too much. You don't want people to judge you. However, your happiness is the most important thing. And I think doing the Empress. Empress is abundance. It is fulfillment. Is happiness. Is be almost Epicurean. You know, have pleasure in pleasure. What's wrong with that? I mean, that's what life is all about, isn't it? And maybe going through what we're going through at the moment that make you really appreciative of what you have, and also enjoy simple pleasure, simple things like good food. Like, you know, it's very important. Those little things, those little moments, sit down, have lunch together, enjoy, you know, each other company or not, and maybe that will be okay. There's something that is not really working. Yeah, and King of Wands. Yeah, I mean, obviously it's gonna be I was surprised this one didn't come out today. Well, bang. Again, you know, it's the decision is gonna be made, and whether you resist it or not, you have a choice to stay in that kind of okay ongoing situation that it doesn't really fulfill you anymore. That did it ever fulfill you anyway from day one, to be discussed. Maybe you just carry on because, you know, you had to carry on, and maybe you had no choice visible at the time, but now you realize it's just like that was okay at the time, but not anymore. And yes, we're going towards calmer water, quieter water after all that stormy weather. So that's wonderful. I mean, again, the very good cards. There's obviously a decision to be made. The decision will be made, and don't push yourself to make the decision. Decision sometime, and quite often in life, is made for you. Life makes sure to do that for you. This magical thing. But don't put pressure on yourself. Be gentle. Be kind to yourself. Appreciate the little thing, the little pleasure in life. Wait to be guided. If you need to move, you will move. If you need to change direction, if you need to leave, you will leave. Just have that faith on the right path will be shown to you. You don't need to make all the decision in life. You don't need to make all the decision in life. Life make the decision for you. For now, just carry on doing your thing. Appreciate every moment. Be present. And everything will be all right. Have a lovely day, and I'll see you tomorrow. Ciao.